Chinese farmer. The farmer and his only son labored through the cold winds of winter and scorching rays of summer with their last remaining horse. One day, the son didn't lock the gate of the stable properly, and the horse bolted away. When neighbors learned what happened, they came to the farmer and said, "What a sadness this is. Without your horse, you'll be unable to maintain the farm. What a failure that your son did not lock the gate properly. This is a great tragedy." The farmer replied, "You may be right." The next day, the missing horse returned to the farmer's stable, bringing along with it 6 wild horses. The farmer's son locked the gate of the stable firmly behind all 7 horses. When neighbors learned what happened, they came to the farmer and said, "What happiness this brings. With 7 horses, you'll be able to maintain the farm with 3 of them and sell the rest for huge profits. What a blessing." The farmer replied, "You may be right." The next day, the farmer's son was breaking in one of the wild horses. The son got thrown from the horse, fell hard on rocks, and broke his leg. When neighbors learned what happened, they came to the farmer and said, "What a great sadness this is. Now you'll be unable to count on your son's help. What a failure to break in the horse properly. What a tragedy." The farmer replied, "You may be right." The next day, a general from the Imperial Chinese Army arrived to conscript all the young men of the village into the army. Their assignment was to fight on the front lines of a battle against a terrifying enemy of overwhelming force. The farmer's son, because of his broken leg, was not taken. When neighbors learned what happened, they came to the farmer and said, "What a great joy. Your son avoided facing certain death on the front lines of the battle. What a blessing." The farmer replied, "You may be right." Moral of the story. Perhaps the story of the Chinese farmer teaches us about a suspension of judgment regarding what actually is a tragedy or a triumph. Can we really always tell what is fortunate and what is unlucky? Might the wiser course of action often be to withhold judgment rather than definitively declare what happens as good or bad? Maybe the story teaches us a radical skepticism, because it is impossible to tell whether anything that happens is good or bad. On the other hand, one might see the story as the farmer's rightful detachment from what is not in his control, matters about which he should be indifferent. Or maybe the story teaches us about how what appears to be bad initially may ultimately be a blessing. Short-term thinking is not always 20/20. At the end of the day, we should be careful labeling the things that happen to us as good or bad. The causal chain of the universe is complex and infinite. Real life stories continue even after the happy ending.